Hello, my name is Dennis Love, and I'm an applications engineer in the Power Modules team at TI. And today I would like to demonstrate to you the LMZM23601 evaluation board. As you know, in a lot of industrial applications, board space dedicated to power management can be very limited. And this module can provide a lot of benefits in such industrial step-down applications and also in inverting applications. Let me give you a few more details about this module family. This module has a 4-volt to 36-volt wide input range. The 23600 is a half-amp version, and the 01 is a 1-amp version of this module. Both of them are available in 3.3-volt and 5-volt fixed outputs, as well as an adjustable output voltage option. It is extremely easy to design with this module. You only need an input and output capacitor for the fixed output voltage options. And as you can see, there is a very small solution size, down to 27 millimeters squared for a 24-volt to 5-volt 1-amp design, with an input cap, a 3.8 by 3 millimeter module package, and an output capacitor. Now I'm going to give you an overview of the EVM and all the connections available on this board. Here we have a test point to monitor the input voltage, and test point to monitor the output voltage, and a ground sense test point as well. We have power terminals to deliver the input power at VIN, ground, and we have output power terminal for the for connecting the load VOUT to ground. On the side of the board, we have test points for direct connections to the mode pin, the enable pin, and the power good pin. On the bottom left here, we have a header to select the enable scheme for the application. The enable pin can be tied directly to VIN. The enable pin is rated for the full input voltage. You could also tie the enable to through a resistive divider to VIN and set the custom under voltage lockout point. And the enable pin can also be driven with a logic signal externally. Selecting that option would allow for that, and the logic signal can be provided at these two test points. On the right, we have the mode select function. There's another header that's available for setting the part in forced PWM mode of operation at light load. This would be very suitable for applications that require constant switching frequency, and typically those are more noise-sensitive applications. We also have the automatic PFM mode of operation, which provides a lot of power savings when the load is in standby. This is for applications that would require very high efficiency at the light load. And we also have an option to synchronize the device with an external clock. You would move the jumper to this header, and you could provide your clock signal at these two test points. There's also a VOUT or power good pull-up voltage selection here. You can pull up the power good pin to output voltage, or you can use an external logic rail that can be provided at these two terminals. We have the output voltage select header that allows you to select an output voltage of 2.5, 3.3, 5 volts, 12 volts, and 15 volts output. In the middle, we have the actual solution. The input capacitor is a 1210 input capacitor on this board. It is designed to handle the entire working range of the module, from 4 volts all the way to 36 volts input. And this capacitor can be a smaller case size, down to 0805, if a narrower input voltage range is available for the application. In the middle, we have the LMZM23601 module. This comes in a 3x3.8 package. We have the, on the right, we have the output capacitors. There's two of them that handle the entire working range from 2.5 to 15 volts. And this could be a single 0805 case size capacitor if a fixed output voltage is used. In the middle, there's two very small resistors that set the output voltage. And these resistors can be are not necessary. They can be avoided if you use the fixed output voltage version of this device. And this would further shrink this small solution size. Now let's connect this board to the power supply and power it up. Here we have a typical bench power supply set to 24 volts output. We have a load resistor. And we have an oscilloscope. The power supply is connected to the board. The input supply is connected at the VN power terminal and the ground power terminal. The load resistor is connected to the Vout power terminal and ground power terminal. The oscilloscope is monitoring the input voltage through the VN sense line, the output voltage through the Vout sense line, and the power good flag through the power grid test point. The default setting is 5 volts on the output, and for the enable we're using a resistor divider to set a custom UVLO point. We have the mode selected at auto PFM mode, and we have the PGood flag pulled up to the output voltage. Okay, let me power up the board. Okay. So we have the input supply ramping up from 0 to 24 volts. As soon as the input supply crosses the UVLO point, the module starts switching and starts ramping up from 0 to final voltage at a soft start time of 4 milliseconds. The load starts at 0 and ramps up to 1 amp. And as soon as the output voltage reaches a regulated value, the power good flag goes from 0 to high 5 volts, indicating that the power is okay. You've seen the LMZM23601 EVM, which is extremely easy to design and provides a very small solution size for many industrial applications. For more information, go to ti.com/powermodules, and thank you for watching.